Just like how the saying goes, curiosity kills the cat, we oftentimes find ourselves in the shoes of Saul, curious and wanting to explore and experience as many adult things as possible. However, the poem tells us that there is no turning back once you choose to open your eyes and gain knowledge on these certain things. There is nothing wrong with learning, but we are prone to getting addicted to the sensation. If we don't fully grasp the consequences of our malicious actions, we will fall deeper and deeper in a hole that we'll soon find a hard time getting out of. The poem conveys a message that there is a right time and age for us to experience these. We must enjoy our innocence and childhood while we still can. While our interpretation may be relatable to younger viewers, this poem is actually based on a biblical character widely known as King Solomon. King Solomon was accredited as the builder of the first temple in Jerusalem. When God gave him an opportunity to choose a gift that he wishes, King Solomon chose wisdom over wealth and power. Because of this, King Solomon became famous and people from far lands came to visit him for consultations, even the Queen of Sheba. However, Solomon experienced a major downfall when he started lusting for foreign women that God himself told him not to be associated with. Solomon had a total of 700 wives and 300 concubines. He even committed idolatry, which is the exact sin against the number one rule from the Ten Commandments. At the end of his life, despite living in luxury and having hundreds of women by his side, he sadly concluded that he gained nothing and everything was meaningless. Solomon was wise enough to know early in his life how he needed to live to please God, and he was wise enough to know, at the end of his life, that his decision to disobey God had produced nothing but emptiness, heartache, and bitterness. In spite of all his wisdom, Solomon had violated God's standards of sexual purity and paid the price for his sin. The story of Solomon tells us how even the greatest of minds can still fall victim to the temptation of sex. In this case, it's a matter of having strong willpower and being able to control one's urges, as this may result to corruption and sin.